सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सहवीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। ॐ पूर्णमदः पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानाम् आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शङ्करं लोकशङ्करं शङ्करं शङ्कराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वन्दे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः। ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। प्रणम्य रामाभिधमात्मधीपदम् जगत्प्रसूतिस्थितिसंयमायनम् तदात्मकान् शङ्करपूर्वकान् गुरून् मयोपदेशार्थविभाग उच्यते। In passage 41 यदि एवं भगवन् किमर्थं श्रुत्या साध्यसाधनादिभेदः उच्यते उत्पत्तिः प्रलयश्चेति। एवं भगवान् ननु साध्य साधन भेदश्चेत् अविद्या विषयः एज़ इट वाज पॉइंटेड आउट एंड एस्टैब्लिश्ड इन अर्लियर डिस्कशन दैट दिस इज साध्य साधन साधक और दिस भेद ऑफ द ड्युअलिटी इज मिथ्या meaning avidya vishaya. It is to meaning it is a product of avidya. It's avidya which is the avaranam which is deprives us of the true knowledge and vikshepa which projects. So whole of this duality of the nature of the seeker, sought, seeking, all of this is the product of ignorance. And second thing is to give reality to that division, that's another thing. So what the Maya does is, it creates this universe of divisions and duality and further creates in us this notion that this duality is real. These two things. That the avidya projects this duality is called Ishvara Srishti. In itself, that is not the problem. As long as we understand that it is creation, more than appearance, so long it doesn't create any problem. So that is all at the level of vyavahara. But the thing that this division is the ultimate reality, that's the reality of what I perceive. So giving reality to the duality of division is the problem. It's called jiva srishti. So Ishvara has created sadhya, sadhana, bheda. And jiva creates the, gives the reality to this bheda. So it's a jiva srishti that is the problem. not the Ishvara Srishti. So in Panchadashi, we have a chapter called Dvaita, you know, so even twofold Dvaita is there. Ishvara Srishti and Dvaita Viveka Prakaram. Recognize that there is twofold Dvaita, Ishvara Srishti and Jiva Srishti. Obviously, Jiva Srishti. What we project upon what we perceive is the problem. And so, is sadhya sadhanadi vedaschet avidya vishaya, meaning that if that duality or division is unreal, is an appearance, tarhi mithyartha gocharatvat, then that bheda is mithya or karmakandam. So karmakanda depends upon, or karmakanda has its basis upon this division of the sadhana, sadhya, sadhaka. Meaning that karmakanda appears to give reality to my conclusion that I am a sadhaka, I am a jiva. And that there is sadhya, something that I have to achieve. And that there is sadhanam, this means of achievement. So this sadhya, sadhaka, sadhana, the division which I think is real, seems to be validated by karmakanda, meaning that the karmakanda also seems to be based on giving reality to the sadhya sadhaka sadhana bheda. And that's how then the Vedas prescribe what you should do to fulfill what desire. Or they also tell us about the desirable ends and say, this is desirable. See, something called swarga is there. It's how wonderful it is. And this is sadhana for that. And if you are a sadhaka, if you are desirous of that swarga, then this is sadhana for you. So this is the orientation or a style of karmakanda. And so it looks as though karmakanda has its basis in duality. And not in duality, in real duality. Now, if as you say, this duality is mithya, the whole karmakanda only seems to be based on something that is mithya. Mithya, the gocharatvat. So karmakanda takes for granted the duality, which is mithya then. So whatever karmakanda talks about sadhanam, sadhya, sadhanam, sadhaka, it also is mithya. So when you say, jyotishtomena swargakamo yajeta, then swarga is sadhyam, swargakama is sadhaka, jyotishtoma is sadhanam. Now all these three are mithya. Meaning that the whole subject matter of karmakanda, the very basis of karmakanda is mithya. Then karmakandam apramanyam syat. The whole karmakanda seems to be based on something which is unreal. Then how can karmakanda be pramanam? How can that be called pramanam, or the valid means of knowledge, that which is basis in something unreal? So this is the, what about, how do you in fact justify the role of karmakanda? When the universe is mithya, so sadhya, sadhana, sadhaka, bheda is mithya, doesn't have reality. Then karmakanda, which has its basis on this duality, how do you explain, how do you justify its existence? Or what role does it have to play? That's the whole idea. What role does karmakanda play in our spiritual growth? Then Tikakar also said, na kevalam karmakanda apramanya apattihi dvaita mithyatve. If dvaita is mithya, just an appearance, and not only karmakanda, which is basis on dvaita, not only that becomes apramanam or invalid, becomes not a source of valid knowledge. In that case, abhidu jnana kandevi, in jnana kanda also, in the Upanishad also, srishtyadi vakyanam, talks about the creation elaborately. Nirvishayada, that means what? Upanishads also describe in detail the process of creation and what this creation is. It is Agnihi, Apaha, Prithvi, having these colors, and so all this elaborately is talked about. Nirvishayata, there is no real Vishaya, meaning there is no really this creation. In reality, that creation is not there. Then Jnana Kanda also talks about creation of something which is not really there. So then that part of Jnana Kanda or Upanishad also becomes a pramanam, meaning that it doesn't talk of something that is real or not something that we can depend upon. So utpatti pralayascha kimartham uchyate. What is the reason, what's the purpose of Karma Kanda describing the Sadhya Sadhaka Sadhana Bheda? And what's the purpose? The Upanishads describing the creation of the universe, what purpose is there? Kimartham? So, to establish the need, the role that these things play. What role does Karma Kanda or Karma play in our life? And what role does the description of creation, etc., play in the taking place of knowledge? So then now we continue Mitika. Tatra Vedanta Vakya Janita Brahmatma Vijnana Prak Karmakanda Pramanya Pattihi Shankyade Tadurdhamva Iti Vikalpya Adyam Prati Aha Atra Uchyade Avidyavataha Upattaide. Now, Karmakanda Apramanya Apatthi, this situation Apatthi of Karma Kanda Apramanya, that Karma Kanda becomes Apramanya, meaning no more remains Pramana. You cannot take as literally true what Karma Kanda says. That's Apramana. Tattvamasi is Pramana because you can literally take what it says. If shabdas, you know, so the meaning of the shabda is meaningful. It describes what is there. So then you say that Karma Kanda cannot be taken literally because it's not pramanam. Is this question for the one? Vedanta Vakya Janita Brahmatma Vijnana Prak? Is it in case of a person in whom the knowledge of the Mahavakya has not taken place? Vedanta Vakya means Mahavakya. Tad janita brahmatma vijnanam, tad janita na vijnanam, knowledge of the fact that Brahma is Atma or Atma is Brahma. So before this knowledge takes place, then the Karma Kanda is a pramanam to durdhamba, or after the knowledge, the Karma Kanda becomes a pramanam. Iti vikalpya. So when you ask this question, from which standpoint you are asking? Are you asking this question from the standpoint of the ignorant person or from the standpoint of an enlightened person? Idi vikalpya, these two options are there, positions are there. Adyam pratyaha. This question is that whether karma kanda apramana even for an ignorant person or enlightened person. For an ignorant person, it remains pramana. This is what answer is given. Atruchyate avidyavataha upattayate. So, the next passage says, Atruchyate avidyavataha upatta shariradi bhedasya ishtanishta yoginam ആത്മാനം മന്യമാനസ്യ സാധനൈഹി ഏവ ഇഷ്ടാനിഷ്ടപ്രാപ്തി പരിഹാര ഉപായ വിവേകം അജാനതഃ ഇഷ്ടപ്രാപ്തിം ച അനിഷ്ടപരിഹാരം ച ഇച്ഛതഃ ശനൈഹി തദ്വിഷയം അജ്ഞാനം നിവർത്തയിതും ശാസ്ത്രം ന സാധ്യസാധനാദിഭേദം വിധത്തേ അനിശ്വരൂപസംസാരോ ഹൈസൈതേ. സോ അവിദ്യാവതഃ, അവിദ്യാവാൻ മീനിങ് വൺ പൊസസ്ഡ് ഓഫ് അവിദ്യ, ഇഗ്നറന്റ് പേഴ്സൺ. ഉപാത്ത ശരീരാദിഭേദസ്യ ആദൌ കർമ്മപ്രസംഗാത്. സോ ബിക്കോസ് ഓഫ് ദി കർമ്മ ഐ ഹാവ് ടു എൻ്റർ ദി വുംബ് ഓഫ് മൈ മദർ അറ്റ്സെട്ര അറ്റ്സെട്ര, ദിസ് ഡിസ്ക്രിപ്ഷൻ ഇസ് ദെയർ. ആൻഡ് സോ ഉപാത്ത ശരീരാദിഭേദസ്യ, സോ വൺ ഹു ഹാസ് അക്വയർഡ് ഉപാത്ത ശരീരാദിഭേദ, സോ ദിസ് ബോഡി ഹാസ് ബീൻ അക്വയർഡ് ബൈ ആൻ ഇഗ്നറന്റ് പേഴ്സൺ. So, an ignorant person thinks that he is a karta bhokta, which will be described. And because he is a bhokta who desires happiness, therefore he becomes a karta to perform the action. And the one who is karta today performing action becomes a bhokta in future to experience the result. That again makes him a karta. So, for fulfilling the desires of becoming free, of gaining the boundless happiness, that's the desire behind all the desires. Ignorant person takes that desire to be real. It begins this way, that a desire arises in my mind, let's say for happiness. But then I give reality to desire, because I give reality to the fact that, or to the experience of my feeling that I'm a seeker of happiness, I'm unhappy as I am right now. I should become happy. For that I should gain that means of happiness. For that I should perform this action, etc., etc. It all starts with giving reality to my desire, which arises from my conclusion that I am an unhappy, limited being as I am. And to become happy, become free, become limitless. So as long as that desire is there, sakama vir jayate tatra tatra, as long as I depart from this body with any desire, it is a desire which makes me take the birth in an appropriate place, which is compatible for fulfilling that desire. So, upatta sharirādi bheda. This bheda means all these dualities, sharira, etc. So, one who acquired body, etc. So, body and sense organs and mind and, you know, this upadhi. So, upatta, one who has acquired this upadhi because of ignorance. The question of the birth arises because I departed from the previous body with a desire. Desire to be happy, desire to be free, etc. And therefore, this body is acquired to fulfill that desire. And therefore, whatever infrastructure is required to fulfill the desire, which is to perform the action. So, performing action requires the gross body, subtle body. All of this is required. Subtle body I already had, but gross body. And then I should be born in a place and situation which is appropriate for fulfilling those desires also. And so if I have desire to acquire wealth, I could not be born in a wealthy family. I could be born in a family which, you know, where there is a lack of wealth, etc. So body, as well as the parentage, as well as the situation where I am born, all of this is in fact determined by my desire. And therefore, all this karma, etc. goes with me, you know. As a result, the vasanas also come with me. And they determine all. So all of this is acquired by an ignorant person who gives reality to his sense of limitation. And therefore, once I acquire this body, etc., then ishtanishta yoginam atmanam manyamanam says, now, let us read the tika here. Aprapte shastram arthavata idi nyayat kartra sadhana phalabheda swarupasya shastra jnana shunyanam viprasiddehe tatra vedasya atatpariyat yatha prasiddham bhedamadaya pumsaha purushada sadhanam avijnatam bodhayataha shastrasya na apramanya shanka iti abhipretya sangruhitam artham vivranote shriradibhedasya ityadina aprapte shastram arthavat. Meaning shastra has its scope with reference to that which is not known to us. Ajnata jnapakam shastram. That is called shastra, which makes us know what is unknown to us or unknowable to us also. Meaning whatever we do not know and whatever we cannot know. Because we have the sense organs of perception and mind and intellect as means of knowledge. And whatever we know or we can know through these available means, for that shastra need not do anything. Shastra does not have pravritti for that which is known to us or that which is knowable to us. That's what is meant by aprapte shastram athavat. It is nyaya. That's the rule. Because shastra is pramanam. Pramanam is valid means of knowledge. So, anadhigatam. So that which is anadhigatam, unknown, not knowable through any so far another means available to me. So that is where the abhaditam and anadhigatam. So any pramanam has its role with reference to the field of knowledge, which is otherwise not available to me with the means available to me now. So whatever I can know by my own buddhi, shastra does not have to teach me that. Now, kartru sadhana phalabheda swarupasya. As far as this duality of karta, the doer, sadhana means of acquiring karma. Phala, sadhana means karma. So karta, karma, phala, these three. Phala is the result that I want. For that sadhana or karma is what I adopt. For that I am the karta, the doer. In shastra jnana shunyana viprasiddhe, this is known to everybody without the need for studying the shastra. I know that I have a desire. I want that thing. That's called the sadhya. And that for that there is always sadhanam. I may, in a given case I may or may not know. But that to achieve that sadhya or end, I need a means. And whether I should perform karma. No, this is known to everybody. Even a little child knows. He gets hungry, then right away he cries and, you know, he knows the means of fulfilling his desire. What to do? So, shastra jnana shunyana api. It is a matter of common knowledge that to fulfill a desire, this is that I should perform an action. So, for that understanding, I need not need the shastra. So, shastra does not have a scope with reference to that which I already know because it will become redundant. Tatra vedasya tatparya. So, veda cannot have tatparya. purport with reference to that which I already know. Of sadhya, sadhanam, sadhaka. In general, I know. I may not know the sadhanam for a particular sadhya. It's possible. But I know that these three things exist in my life. The sadhya, sadhaka, sadhanam. This triad is there that I know. Yatha prasiddham bhedamadaya. And every ignorant person takes that bheda. I am a sadhaka. I am separated from sadhya by time, place or condition. And that gap or, you know, the distance between sadhaka and sadhya has to be bridged by sadhanam. This basic knowledge I have. You follow? This we know. That's why child also goes, you know, crawls towards something that it sees, which it wants. No, that is sadhya. This is sadhanam. I am sadhaka. So it may not know the words, etc. But this is known. And therefore, yatha prasiddham bhedam. This bheda or the duality is something that is taken for granted by everybody, even those who have not had any occasion of studying the scriptures. So Gopala, even the cowherd people also know, those who have never gone to school. Pumsa purusadas purushatas avignatam bodhayataha. Purushartha is purushai arthyate, that which is desired and that is desired by a person, by human being. So he knows he wants something, but sadhanam avignatam, but does not know how to acquire that. He knows I want to be happy. Doesn't know how to be happy. What will make me happy? I want, you know, security, I want peace, etc. Doesn't know what will give me peace. Or may not, I may know what gives me happiness, doesn't know how to acquire it. So he has a desire, but may not know what the sadhya, what is it that will fulfill his desire, he may not know. Or he may know what will fulfill desire, but may not know what's the means of fulfilling the desire. So purushartha sadhanam avignatam bodhayatah. Shastrasya na pramanya shankha. So therefore, shastra bodhayata shastrasya. The shastra is in fact enlightening us, teaching us, making us understand what is unknown to us as to the means of achieving a given end. I may know what end I want, I do not know the means of achieving that end. So known and unknown means. Known means unknown end. Means I perform this karma, Agnihotradi, but I do not know what it will lead me to. Or unknown end and unknown means. I did not know that there is something called Swarga. So that is made to be known to me, and then what's the means of attaining that Swarga? So known means unknown end, unknown means, you know, known end, unknown means unknown end. This is where the scope is of the Vedas. Where the means is known and end also is known, then there is no scope. So Vedas have the scope. So Shastrasya na pra. So that means that there is a field of knowledge which is not available to me with the means of knowledge at my disposal. The means of knowledge at my disposal, I do not know many things that can make me happy. I do not know many actions or means by which end can be attained. So many unknown means and ends are there in my life. So Shastra in fact gives you knowledge of what is unknown to me. That's the whole idea. There are many ends I do not know. There are many means I do not know. And Shastra gives you knowledge of ends and means that are unknown to me. That's why it is Pramana. If it tells me something that I already know, then it's not Pramana. But there are unknown things which I need to know. Unknown things can be there. I not care for that. So he's a video, describe this thing, you know what this means, let him do what. So many things we don't care to know. There are unknown things, but I don't care to know them. So many things come, one another, I read that, 2 minutes, there's no way that you can, give time to that, so it's not gone. The one who signs things, that Swami has seen everything, but you can't. So, you don't care to know many things. But then there are things that you care to know, and you do not know. So this is where Shastra becomes Pramanam. So Shastra na Pramanya Shankayati Shastrasya. There is a scope for Shastra in our life to make us know what we want to know. Shastra only makes us know. Doesn't make us do, but it just makes us, then we decide whether to do or not. So Sanghitam Artham Vivranati. So now, what is Sanghitam? I don't know. Atra Uchyate. That's only Sanghitam. So, Sharira Adi Vedasya Adi Upatta Sharira Adi Vedasya. Should be. Avidyavada Upatta. So, Sharira Adi Veda is something that is acquired by an ignorant person. Okay, Sanghitam Artham is the Shastra Pramanyam. That Shastra is Pramanam. That's the artha that is being explained now. So then the passage say, Upatta Shariradi Vedasya Ishtanishta Yoginam Atmanam Manyamanasya. The one Manyamanasya, understand. So because of ignorance, that is this conclusion. Or my understanding that Ishtanishta Yoginam Atmanam Manyamanasya. Then I'm Ishtanishta Yogi. I'm connected with what is Ishta desirable or connected with what is undesirable. Then I'm connected or I can be connected. I'm connected and I can be connected. I'm connected with Ishta, something desirable. Then also there is desire to protect it. You understand? Yoga and Kshema. So even when I am, as long as I think I am connected with even desirable, then also there is a desire to protect it. And I am connected, unconnected with what is desire, then also I desire to connect myself. So Ishta Anishta Yoginam Atmanam Manyamanasya. One who believes that is connected with Ishta and Anishta. Meaning that I am not adequate as I am now. And therefore, I must have something Ishta that is desirable to become adequate. Or I am adequate as long as this desirable thing is there. And its absence will be inadequate, then I must retain that adequate, desirable thing. So Ishta and Anishta both create desires. Anyway, so as long as my conclusion is that there is something desirable in my life and undesirable in my life. That what is desirable can make me adequate, what is undesirable should be kept away because it affects my adequacy. Once you think so, then you are a desirer. Manyamanasya. Sadhani eva ishta anishta prapti parihara upaya vivek majanatah. But ajana, I do not know. The upaya, I do not know the means. The something ishta desirable is there. I do not know the means of achieving or acquiring the desirable. I know that it is undesirable. I do not know how to keep it away. So ishta, anishta, prapti, ishta prapti, that's how the samasa is. Ishta prapti, anishta, parihara. That's ithasankyam, connecting. Ishta, anishta, prapti, parihara. Upaya vivekam ajanatah. What is a clear means of attaining what is desirable or avoiding what is undesirable, two things I want. So, sukha prapti, dukha nivritti. Sukha is istam desirable, dukha is anistam undesirable. sukhaprapti. I naturally want to acquire happiness and want to get rid of unhappiness also. So dukkham is anishtam and sukham is ishtam. Sukha is desirable, therefore whatever I think will make me happy also becomes desirable. And whatever I look upon as the means of unhappiness makes that thing undesirable. Thus, my life consists of things that are desirable and undesirable. Desirable because I look upon them as a means of happiness. Undesirable because I look upon them as means of unhappiness. Then desire is for both of them. Something desirable, then I want it. Undesirable, I want to get rid of it. If I do not know how to get what I want, or get rid of what I do not want. So, ishta anishta prapti parihara upaya vivekam ajanata. What's the means to do that? Means of acquiring what I want or getting rid of what I do not want. Now, there is a scope that Shastra has now. Shastra has scope with reference to what I do not know and what I need to know. I understand. What I do not know and what I need to know, that is where Shastra has a scope. So, there can be many things in Shastra. There can be geology and zoology and all kinds of things can be there, because there are fellows who may want to know that. I may not care to know them, but there are people who want to know what is this, you know, insects and what is this bird and what is, you know. So the whole life is centered on that. So them, that part of Shastra becomes important, you know. So, ishta praptim cha anishta pariharam cha ichchatah. Desiring the ishta prapti, you know, acquiring what is desirable, getting rid of undesirable. Shanaihi tadvishyam agnyanam nivartayatum shastram. So tadvishyam agnyanam I do not know what is the sadhanam for ishta prapti or anishta nivritti. And therefore, Shastra wants to remove that ignorance pertaining to what is important for me. What is important for me is to know how to acquire happiness or how to get rid of unhappiness. If I do not know, then Shastra makes me know. So, agnyanam nivartinta. So, Shastra wants to remove the ignorance with reference to the ishta prapti sadhanam and anishta nivritti sadhanam. So, this is what Shastra scope is. So let's see what the Tikakara says. Sadhanehi eva ishta praptim cha anishta pariharam cha icchatah ishta anishta prapti parihara upaya vivekam ajanatah shanehi tadvishyam agnyanam nivartayitum shastram iti anvayaha. So this, the Tikakara gives us the prose order because the words are not arranged in proper order. So this is how the whole vakya is to be understood. Sadhani eva ishta praptim cha anishta parisaram cha icchatah. So he desires the attainment of what is desirable, getting rid of what is undesirable, and he wants to know the means of that. If he doesn't care, I know that this is not desirable, I don't care if it comes. Suppose somebody says, or I know that is desirable, I don't care if it does not come. Meaning that somehow it is, you know, he doesn't, that desire for means does not arise in him. Then Shastra, then nobody can do anything to this fellow, you know. If a desire does not arise, then nobody has any scope. Shastra doesn't have a scope and world also doesn't have a scope. Although, moment you call something desirable, that will create a desire. To remain free from desire, the wise person doesn't look upon anything as desirable or undesirable, then only desire cannot come. Moment I brand something desirable, my mind will want it. Undesirable wants to get rid of it. But anyway, So, and then doesn't know the upaya, the means, and so slowly, shanaihi, slowly the scripture wants to remove the ignorance pertaining to what is, what I need to know. In my, to live my life, I need to know something. And scripture removes ignorance pertaining to that. This shanaihi, slowly it removes ignorance. The primary ignorance is the ignorance of the self. And primary thing that I want is moksha. But right now he says, don't worry about all that stuff. Right now, you do what we ask you to do. As the Tikakar will nicely explain. So slowly the self-ignorance is removed. The primary objective of the scripture is to remove self-ignorance. With self-ignorance, the grossest expression of self-ignorance is raga-dvesha. And then so we have the whole sequence. Raga-dveshas arise because of the karma, they arise because of the abhimanam, they arise because of ignorance, etc. So progressively ignorance will be removed. Meaning scripture does not start right away with self-knowledge. He wants to remove ignorance, all right. But ignorance has many expressions. The primary ignorance is the ignorance of the self, avaranam. That creates the identity, identification with the body-mind-sense complex, which is the abhimanam. That creates ahankara, sense of individuality. Then that creates raga-dvesha. So raga-dvesha is the most, I mean the grossest expression of ignorance. From that you go to ahankara or ego, sense of individuality. From that you go to abhimanam, the identification of the body. From that you go to knowledge of the self. So thus this is the way the ignorance has to be removed in this particular sequence. There is a method of helping this individual or human being to ultimately achieve the goal of his life, which is moksha, which he also may not know. But then, that's what it is. So shanaihi, as the Tikakara will explain, progressively, slowly or progressively, the ignorance is removed by Shastra. Now the Tika further says, so that anvaya is given, now explanation is given. Sadhanaihi eva ishtanishta prapti parihare chayam nimittam visheshantarena dyotayanna aha sharira iti. So sadhanaihi ishtanishta prapti. This person desires to accomplish something that is desirable by sadhanam, by means in his mind arises the need to know the sadhanam. So what arises in our mind is the need to know what is the means by which I can fulfill the desire. So desire arises. You need not do anything about that. Then when desire arises, then next thing arises in my mind is a desire to know how I can fulfill this desire. What is the means to fulfill that desire? Naturally, that's the next question. If I do not know that means, then I must go to where that knowledge can come from. So sadhani eva ishtanishta prapti parihara ichhaya. So there is a desire of achieving what is desirable. What's the means of that? What's the means of getting rid of what is undesirable? So there is a desire in me to know the sadhanam. What's the nimittam? Why does that desire arise? Visheshanantaran dyotanaha upatta shariradi bhedasya. Because I have shariradi bheda, because of identification with the sharira. So first is avidyavataha. First visheshan is that this person is ignorant. Second Vishesan is that ignorance causes him, Upatta Shariradi Vedasya causes him to acquire and identify with the different bodies. So everybody has a different body. I also have a different body in different births, depending upon what is the nature of ignorance. Meaning, what is the nature of ignorance? What's the nature of desire? That desire is the expression of ignorance. That causes raga dveshas and whatever. So, first visheshan is avidyavataha. Second visheshan is upatta shariradi bhedasya. So again explaining the Tikagara says, Sharirade Vedasya Sharirendriya Sharirendriyari Sanghata Visheshasya Sammandhini Ya Ishtaniste Tadyuktam Atmanam Manyamanasya Iti Yojana. So text said, Upatta Shariradi Vedasya Ishtanishta Yoginam Atmanam Manyamanasya Sadeva Ishtanishta, etc. So says here, Shariradi Vedasya means what? What is this multiplicity or variety of Sharira, etc.? Shari Indriyadi Sangata Vishesha. Sharira also is there, and sense organs are there, mind also is there, intellect also is there. So this Sangata, this aggregate or assemblage of the body, etc. Sammandiniya Ishtanishta Manyamanasya. So one who believes that Ishta and Anishta, the desirable and undesirable, are connected to me. Who am I? I am the Shariradi Sangata. So, having identified the body-mind-sense complex, therefore, the limitations of the body-mind-sense complex being my limitations, therefore, I look upon myself as limited or inadequate beings. And the moment I feel a sense of inadequacy, there is immediate desire of becoming adequate or becoming free from sense of inadequacy. So, inadequacy means dukkham. Adequacy means sukham. So, both are the same. Become free from inadequacy is free from dukkha. Become adequate means becoming sukhi. So then, when I look upon myself as the seeker of happiness or seeker of lack of unhappiness or freedom from unhappiness, then something becomes ishta and anishta, becomes desirable. That which can fulfill my desire is desirable. That which can obstruct my desire is undesirable. So I become then connected with that. I become the desirer of what is desirable. Become desirer of getting rid of what is undesirable. So, tadyuktam atmanam yoginam yuktam. That I am the one who is possessed of the, who is connected with ishta and anishta. Who is impacted by the desirable and undesirable. The desirable creates in me the impact of acquiring that. The undesirable creates in me the impact of getting rid of that. If I don't think that something can be connected to me, there are millions of things. I don't think it has any role in my life. I don't become desirable, you know. So everything doesn't create impact on me. Only few things create impact on me. My creating a desire of acquiring or getting rid of. Again, Tikakara explains. Ayam bhavaha anadi avidya avrata nijasvabhavasya sarirendriya manobuddhi praneshu adhyastatmabhavasya Parichinnam Atmanam Manyamanasya Swatirikta Vishayas Sammanda Adhinameva Purushartham Ichchataha Tadupayam Pariyeshamanasya sakshat purushartham atmatattvam buddhum asamartattvat prathamam tat abhilashita swargadi sukhadi sadhanam manantarat avijnatam bodhayata shastram tam vidinishedayoho vyavasthapayate. So beautifully the whole logic of Shastra, the role of Shastra in life is explained here. Anadi avidya avrata nijasvabhavasya avaranam. Avrata nijasvabhavasya, one for whom the nijasvabhava, the true nature of oneself is veiled, is unknown. Meaning, I do not know what my true nature is, and that ignorance is beginningless. Meaning, this is naisargikam. The ignorance is naisargikam, means it is ongoing ignorance. And therefore, I do not know the true nature of myself. Therefore, what happens? Sharira indriya mano buddhi praneshu adhyasthatma bhavasya. So then there is a desire. For that I need to acquire a body, or upadhi. What is meant by acquiring upadhi is establishing the identity with that. So, adhyasthatma bhavasya in sharira, indriya, and what? Mano, buddhi, prana. This is a sanghata. And then identification of body, sense organs, mind, intellect is again a habitual stuff. So habitually I do not know the true nature of myself, and therefore habitually I see myself as a needy individual, and therefore I acquire a upadhi of body, mind, sense complex, which will be appropriate for fulfilling those needs. And therefore, parichannam atmana manyamanasya. Moment I identify with a given set of body, mind, complex, then I become as small or as limited as that body, mind, sense complex. And therefore, I am the body, I am limited. So, parichinnam atmanam manyamanasya. Looking upon oneself as parichinnam, as limited, is inadequate. Limited also is not a problem. Inadequate is a problem. I am limited, I don't care. Then there is no problem. I don't have $1,000,000, it doesn't matter. So limitedness also is not a problem. Inadequacy is a problem. If I think that because of not having something inadequate, then I cannot accept. I cannot accept inadequacy centered on myself. Because I want to see myself as an adequate being. Therefore, parichinnam atmanam manyamanasya. So looking upon oneself as inadequate. Then, svatirikta vishaya sambandha adhinameva purushartham icchadaha. Then there is artha, purushartha, something that is desirable by me because I am inadequate. So naturally I look upon something as a means of removing that inadequacy. So I project upon myself some inadequacy, and I project upon something else the means of making me adequate. That both projections happen. Projection upon the self, where I superimpose inadequacy, and projection upon the non-self, the world, which I look upon as a means of removing my inadequacy or means of making myself adequate. Therefore, sva-atirikta vishaya sambandha. Since I am inadequate, therefore, I look upon something else that is different from myself as that which will make me free from inadequacy. So purushartham icchadaha. So now he wants an end which is different from me. So it's wealth, name, fame, heaven, whatever. Progeny, family. So whatever I think is a means of becoming free from inadequacy or making me adequate is not different from me. So svatirikta, that's important. That sadhya, I'm a sadhaka. Sadhya is svatirikta, different from the sadhaka. There is sadhanam, which will bridge that gap between sadhya and sadhaka and sadhya. tadupayam pariyeshamanasya. Now I search for upayam. What is the means that will fulfill my desire? Really speaking, only Atma-jnanam can fulfill that desire. The desire behind all the desires is to become limitless, to become adequate. And only way that I can become adequate is to know that I am already adequate. Because limitless can never be attained. Nasti akrutah krutena. Akrutah uncreated. The eternal limitless cannot be attained. It has to be known. So really it is self-knowledge which is the means. But right now, Atma-tattvam bodh sakshat purushartham Atma-tattvam bodhnum asamartatvad. Really what is purushartha is the self. Or self-knowledge is the real purushartha. So real end what I am seeking is moksha. That is the purushartha. The means of achieving that end is Atma-jnanam, self-knowledge. So that is what actually the Vedas should give me, self-knowledge. Why are they taking me right? Why do they do all this stuff? Why do not the Vedas start with self-knowledge right away? Vedas know that what I need is moksha, which is already my nature. And I think that I am bound, that bondage is a notion. All I need in my life is to remove that notion. Like those cow, that cow which thought that I am bound. All you need is to create to remove that notion by that chesta of untying the cow. Similarly also, this fellow is already free and has to be made known that you are free. But then, sakshat purushatam atmatattvam bodhum asamatattvat. Right now, I do not possess the maturity of the mind or the subtlety of the mind by which I can know the Atma. Drushyadetu agriya buddhya sukshmaya sukshmadarshibhi. What we need is sukshma buddhi, ekagra buddhi, which I don't have right now. So Veda knows. So if an 8-year-old child asks, or a 6-year-old, to dad, hey, how does the rain come? So dad is a big professor of physics and start explaining to him, how the rain, the whole mechanism of rain, so how evaporation takes place. You may talk of surface tension, all kinds of things you can talk about, That fellow dozes off in 1 minute. And when the dad finishes the lecture, he wakes up and goes away from the dad doesn't know. And he goes to mother. So, mom, how does rain come? Beta, above the sky there is heaven. Yes. And there are devatas. Yes. Indra is the king of devatas. Yes. He's an elephant upon which he rides. Yes. His name is Airavata. He's a white elephant. Yeah. He has four, trunks. Yes. Then he takes elephant to a lake. Elephant is thirsty, so takes him to drink water. Elephant drinks, goes into the water, drinks water. Elephant is a naughty animal. Then it plays and then it starts sprinkling the water. So this is what rain is. Yes, now I understand. Dad doesn't know anything, mom. So, bodhum asamarthatvat. At this point, this child is asamartha, incapable of understanding what it is that brings about the rain. And so you give him the means which right now will be all right for him, so he can proceed in his life to a point where he can understand. So you must bring this child to a point of maturity where he is now ready to understand. Then you can tell him. Pratham, tat abhilashito. Right now, what does he want? In fact, the desire behind the desire is moksha. But he thinks that I want heaven because that is moksha for him. Sukhaprapti is the desire. But he does not know that what he is seeking is the niritisham sukham, limitless happiness. He thinks that heaven provides me or will provide what I want. Therefore, tat abhilashita sargadhyukasadhanam. Tasya abhilashita. What he desires, says, is swarga. The sadhanam means for fulfilling his desire of becoming adequate. All right. If that sadhanam he knows, then also Vedas the onoscope. So he is hungry. He knows what sadhanam? Eating is a means of appeasing hunger. Then you don't need Vedas to tell him that, hey, when you are hungry, then you eat this. You know? Because he knows it anyway. But manantarat avijnatam. So even he wants heaven, which is what? Let's say the means is known to him, but does not know how to achieve that heaven. With the means of knowledge available to him, he does not know how to attain swarga. So manantarat avijnatam, that is what is apraptam. Is what manantarat avijnatam. So tasmin arthe shastram arthavat. Shastra is a pramanam. Every pramanam has this scope, in fact. Anadigatam. Every pramanam gives us knowledge which cannot be gained by available means. That's all. So eyes will give us knowledge of colors and forms which cannot be known through any other means, like ears, etc., other organs of perception, or the mind or intellect also. You cannot know color by the mind. Only eyes are required. With mind, but eyes. Meaning that every pramana means of knowledge has a unique scope, unique vishaya. So manantarat avijnatam sadhanam, that jyotishtoma is this sadhanam, the means of attaining swarga, which this fellow does not know. Bodhayat. That's what the shastra makes him know. At the same time, the mother will give, he wants chocolate, that mom will give. But a clever mom, what he does? Well then, you know, you do this. Sit down here and remove this, you know, the what they are called rice picking. Means give a rice, pick all the stones, something will be given. Then he gets this similarity. Shastra says, vidhi nishedayo vyavasthapayati. If you want swarga, then you should do this and not do that. That's how discipline comes in life. So first of all, Shastra makes this person a disciplined person. A person who has self-control. Who follows values. You must speak truth. You must observe brahmacharya during this time. Like the Ayyappa fellows, you know, for 41 days brahmacharya. Wear black clothes. So nobody can be attracted to you when you think, I guess that may be the reason, I don't know, whatever it is. Then anyway, the black also must have some other significance. And you must perform prayers and puja every evening. And observe fast only once a day. You should. So these restrictions are there. If you want to go to the temple. Otherwise these fellows are, you know, if you look at their wild fellow animals, their life otherwise. But when they go to the upper temple, they do all this. 41 days. They become sadhus, literally. His hope that will persist also, subsequently. It may disappear, who knows, but it may persist and then bring about a slow change in this person. So this is how you should not give away anything without the appropriate price that fellow should pay. Don't give them away because then there is no value. So people who give them money also, they extract the condition. So when the earthquake was there and the real people, good people, the NGOs, helped the people to build villages, but then they had to participate. So you act as masons and act as bricklayers and do this. And they will give you this and you'll get your house. So that is how you should make them do things. Recognize the value of labor. Recognize the value of what they are given. Then a sense of gratitude will arise, you know, that will change them. So this is a scheme that the Vedas follow. We'll continue. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate Om Shanti Shanti Shanti.
Shankaram Shankaracharyam Keshavam Badarayanam Sutra Bhashya Krutau Vande Bhagavantau Punah Punah Ishvaro Guru Ratmeti Murti Bheda Vibhagine Vyoma Vyapta Dehaya Dakshina Murtaye Namah Om Shanti 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 Hari Om Shri Gurubhyo Namah Hari Om.